block away from where we were headed, Miss Bernadette noticed an odd little tent. I'd been by this spot at least 3 times that day and hadn't noticed it. The tent was red and white striped, with a poorly carved wooden sign above the opening that read, Pearl's Palm Readings, $1.
Well, ain't you precious? Give me your hands.
When she touched my hands, her body jerked as if a bolt of electricity had gone through it. I jumped back, trying to take my hands with me, but her grip was too strong. Her eyes rolled into the back of her head, and then her head dropped backwards. After one horrifying moment of the rest of us looking around at one another, her head lifted slowly. She turned her gaze slowly until her eyes rested on Ray.
You haven't done right by Mouse, Ray.
All these years, I tried hard to remember the sound of my mother's voice and failed. As soon as Miss Pearl spoke, I remembered. Tears started stinging my eyes, but I refused to cry. I had to focus on the rest of what she had to say.
You took me from my baby. A girl child has a tough time learning to be a woman without her mother. That won't go unanswered, Ray. You such a strong girl, Mouse. I'm so proud of you, my love. I've watched you since you left Maplewood. Miss Janie, Mr. Earl, and Miss Sookie took good care of you. I made sure of it. I'm always with you. I'm always with you.
Miss Pearl slowly seemed to regain her own consciousness. Once she was able to gather herself, she turned and looked at Ray.
Leave this here tent and don't you never come back. You couldn't have saved her. You was too little and it worked for you to do. You supposed to be who you supposed to be because of what happened to you.
I told y'all this was a bunch of bullshit.
What's she talking about, Ray?
Sugar, I know you don't believe that shit.
What's she talking about, Ray?
I ain't defending myself from no half-crazy old woman.
It's the truth.